Sorry, convicted trash titan Chuck Rizzo Jr. is back out on the streets. It comes just a week after he was sentenced for bribing politicians and stealing money from his own garbage hauling firm. Dave Llewellyn here right now with the new decision from a federal judge on this.
Now, Rizzo's been locked up, Carolyn, since February when he contacted a potential witness in his case. He was sentenced April 23rd to 5.5 years, and he's waiting to head to prison. But Rizzo asked the court to set him free so we can get some personal affairs in order before he begins serving a sentence. And U.S. District Judge Robert Leland approved his request. It contained 4 points. One involved Rizzo's oldest son, who's cognitively disabled. Rizzo wants time to deal with school issues. Second, his youngest son will be attending a new school. Rizzo wants to help ease his transition. He also wants to help with his family's financial planning before he goes off to prison, and he wants to be there for his mother when she gets surgery in a few weeks. Now, Rizzo had to put up $10,000 to get released on bond. He'll have to report once a week until he goes to prison. He has to stay here in southeastern Michigan. Also, he's not allowed to have any contact with co-defendants, victims, or witnesses in this case. Prosecutors have fought Rizzo's release, saying he could hurt himself because he apparently talked about doing that 2 years ago. And when he's reunited with his families, prosecutors fear he could have an emotional breakdown. The court didn't feel those concerns were substantial enough to keep Rizzo locked up, however. Once he's done handling these personal matters, he's expected to voluntarily check himself into prison.
Well, certainly a big case there. Thank you so much, Dave. All right, crews have finished capping and sealing two electric cables that were severed in the Straits of Mackinac last month. A team of investigators led by the Coast Guard are still trying to determine exactly what caused the damage. State officials claim a tugboat anchor struck the lines on April 1st. The damage caused about 600 gallons of coolant to leak into the Straits. Another 625 gallons were recovered from the severed cables. All right, let's take you back outside now for a live look over Comerica Park. The Tigers are hosting a 3-game series against the Tampa Bay Rays this week. Dave Rexroth is tracking a chance for rain and tomorrow's game, but for tonight, it doesn't get much better than what it's doing right now, right, Dave?
The sun is great. You can see it's a beautiful shot in the state. Look at those numbers, too. 84 outside right now in Detroit. Impressive. Average highs, 65 to 67 this week, all right, first week of May. And the records are 85 to 90. We're at 84 now. The record high today is 86. We're awfully close to that. Impressively warm. Maybe it's just because we wanted the Tampa players to feel comfortable under. Here are the numbers right now. 81 in Port Huron, 83 in Mount Clemens, 84 in Troy and Detroit. All spots in the 80s right now. We'll get back to around 80 tomorrow as well, but this is the night to enjoy. I will tell you the reason we've gotten so warm is because the air is very dry, just like on the desert, that heats it up extremely and quickly, and so we'll cool off, just like in the desert with the dry air this evening as well. So first pitch, 81 degrees at least with sunshine. By the middle innings, already down to 74, a significant drop, and then mid-60s by the end of the game. Now, clear skies, not breeze that bothers you too much, but I'll tell you, you're going to look silly in the crowd, but take a jacket if you're going because you will need it as the game gets a little bit cooler here.